Oh, hello there, everybody. Today we're gonna edit this picture right here and we're gonna make it look like this. Da, 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 da. Yeah, so that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna do it in Lightroom only. No other tools will be used. This picture, I did not take it myself. This picture is one of Claire Firth. This particular image was from a product shoot for the makers of this collar and this coat. And we're basically gonna take this flat image because of the lighting conditions at the time, and we're gonna make it go wow. That's kind of it. Going to move right on over into the develop module right now. So we're in the develop section. As you can see, I've done nothing to this picture, and I'm just going to edit this like how I would normally edit it. Now, as it's a product shot, usually they're going to be on an online gallery, so generally the image aspect ratio will be square. For the purposes of this actual tutorial though, I'm just going to use a 10x8 landscape. So to switch between landscape and portrait, just press X on your keyboard. And the reason why I've gone with that basically is because that still has this most of the coat in. I mean, the main detail on the coat is this area. So I'm probably just going to go in like that, just like so. Okie dokie, so I'm going to go ahead and just start working on some little things. So very, very flat. So I desperately need to add some punch back into this image. Now I could do that with the tone curve, or I could just go ahead and start using my slider. So I'm just going to drop the blacks down because there wasn't any. I mean, let's be honest, that's grey. So if you look, there's nothing in the black section of that histogram. We're going to give some blacks back. So that's bringing the blacks in. We're going to also bring down the highlights, because what that does is that'll move the histogram over and it'll bring back some of this sky. I'm also going to bring some of the shadows down a little bit. The mid-tone area, you know, I'm not too fussed about at the moment. You could lift that if you really wanted to, but I'm only going to go back and add more over it. For this image, we probably would want to not knock texture out of it. So in my normal work, I probably would just reduce the texture on that. So I'm going to leave that. I'm going to go into detail. So I'm going to zoom in again, big screen. So I'm going to go in to 200%. I'm going to up the sharpening on the whole image quite a bit. I'm going to increase the radius by holding down my Alt key. I'm just getting to the point where I'm quite happy with that. The detail will probably bring out the noise. Yep, so we can just go ahead and sort of bin that off halfway. Noise reduction, yes, I want to assess some of this situation happening here, so I'm going to increase my luminance. And then I'm going to hold down my Alt key, use the detail tab to bring in some detail, and then the contrast to bring in some contrast. How are we going? Okay, I'm happy with that. That's good, that's good. I'm gonna add more sharpening though. Beautiful. That's nice, that's nice. I'm gonna add a vignette, slight negative vignette, just around the edge, like so. Before and after, we are, what are we, like a few minutes in? Da 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 da. The whole image, we don't want to mess with the colour too much, but I am going to make it warmer because people like warm pictures and it makes them feel happy. I don't know if that's scientifically proven, but I'm pretty sure it should be. And we're going to start working on the background. So in Lightroom, we want to go ahead to go to the radial filter. I'm going to bang that over the subject's head, which is right here. And I'm going to drop the highlights again a little bit more. We need to move that in a bit. I'm not okay with that. We just want to really leave this dog's face alone, like so. Totally different. I'm going to bring that back a little bit on the exposure because it's not needed that much. I'm going to just drop the texture, everything outside of it just a little bit, not too much. I'm going to go and get the brush tool. Nice big brush, nice big brush. I'm going to drop the, just whilst I know what I'm looking at on my, I've just got it at exposure quite low, just so that I know what I'm looking at. I'm going to go over the areas of the image which are far brighter than the subject. is about the a before and an after on that brushwork. I'm just going to remove it off the ear, so I'm going to go erase. I have absolutely no idea why I'm singing. I'm really sorry about this, because I don't usually sing, like, ever. I'm just happy. I'm going to put that brush back on, using my square brackets to change the size of the brush. I'm just going to go back closer to the edges there. Perfect. New brush, and we're going to go with Sharpen Eyes brush. I really need to save that preset. You know what? I'm going to save this preset. There is a video, I will link to it above, with a preset for this. I'm just going to make a preset right now, so bear with me 2 secs. Looking good. I want more contrast. Like, I just feel there's just not enough going on for me here in this picture. I'm gonna go ahead and use the tone curve. Before and after. This is looking really nice. Really nice. As this is a product shot, I probably would just go ahead and up the texture and clarity on the product, because it's like leather sort of effect. I'm really happy with that. Like, I would just stop now, to be honest, because do you need to do anything else? It would be nice to take the edge of that collar off. If this was a product shoot, that there should really be a product stylist on the shoot. Ideally, you would just rubber band that to the neck at the other side. I might go back to the background brush. Blah, 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 blah. The background brush that I made, and I'm just going to play a little bit about softening off the background even more than I already have done. Because why not? When you drop the clarity, it also drops the contrast, so just keep that in mind. And when you increase the contrast, that increases the saturation, so also keep that in mind. I'm just going to go ahead and do a little bit of contouring on the dog. And I'm just going to raise the eye a little bit more. And there's still a bit of blue coming through the coat, so I'm just going to tweak that colour level again to be slightly warmer. Yeah, right, stop. Beautiful. So before and after on that, let's go with the split shot. Amazing. Amazing. So I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you have, please subscribe. Honestly, please, please, please subscribe. It makes such a difference to my whole life. Like this video, comment, ask questions, join our Facebook group. Enjoy your weeks. Bye-bye.